Good afternoon, traders. It's Bill Baruch with Blue Line Futures, and this is what's moving. Long holiday weekend, and coming out of it, there's a lot of momentum, big risk on, and that momentum is behind normalization right now. Obviously, you saw a lot of traffic out and about over the Memorial weekend throughout the country, and then as well, globally, you're seeing some restrictions being loosened. You have Japan coming out of the national emergency as well. They lifted that. You're hearing borders and travel being opened in Europe potentially, but overall, risk on across the board. Stocks were up sharply, and then they did peel back just a little bit ahead of the end of the session. Let's take a look at the heat index. You can see here that it was a move in the banks. They were strong. You had industrials moving well, but the tech lagged. In fact, the NASDAQ lost ground and finished red at the end of the session, 200 points off the high of the day. And if you look here, it was the banking. This is the regional bank index here, the KRE, up 8.5% today. It came off that low middle of May, and it has just been on a tear. Yeah, this is an 8.5% bar daily right here. And that really fueled, you're seeing the banks fueling gains across the board, the S&P, as well as the Russell 2000. I think two-thirds of the KRE is in that Russell 2000. But in the S&P, that little bit of a stumble before the end of the session did not allow it to close above the 200-day moving average. It really settled right at that 200-day moving average. We like to think of a decisive close above there, and that was not that today. So we're right at this 200-day. Tomorrow will be an interesting session. Overall, though, you can see here the NASDAQ left quite a tail. But at the other side of it, you get this little bit of a technical turn. You now have the 50-day moving average crossing out above the 200, which started to happen late last week. So, you know, overall, we're seeing a nice move here. And then this is, again, this is at 9,000. This will be our point of balance. You know, any sharp sell-off, and we were going to sell off. I mean, today, we were 200 points off the high. It's not that far away considering that 9,000 is going to be a huge, huge area to keep an eye on. But as well, the treasuries, you see, this is the risk-off move, pressure in treasury prices, yields lifted, and then overall, there's a little consolidation here through the session. Before the end of the day, we saw the 10-year pick back up a little bit. It did come off, but pick back up a little bit. A little bit of demand coming in there for safe havens. Now, speaking of safe havens, this was a very poor day for gold, but we've been talking about this. In fact, last week right here, I talked about potentially seeing gold hug 1700 going into today's options expiration for the big June contract. But once we get through this options expiration, and then we get through the June contract expiry later this week, it's going to help lift the ceiling for gold. Gold should come out. Are very bullish gold. And in fact, like I said, we were prepared for this and it settled right into that 1700 area. You had nearly 7,000 open interest in the 1700 puts, 7,000 open interest in the 1700 calls, and it just comes right there like a magnet. And that's exactly what we saw here today. But take a look at the gold chart. There's also a nice little trend line going back into this April low. We held into that pretty good. And then you got the 50-day moving average rising slowly here, and it's coming to their support. So we like gold a lot. We're still positioned cautiously bullish gold, but we're just going to see how this plays in through the next 12 hours or so to tomorrow, and we may be looking to take on a bit more risk. Recommend to our clients to take on a bit more risk. On top of that, really, it's that June contract expiry later this week. And if you look back, we've talked about it, June last year. It was the day after that thing went off. Gold just started ripping and never looked back. It was at about 1286, straight up to 1500 almost over the next few months. So keep in mind, this is where you want to be a buyer in gold. This is not where you want to be panicking out. But as well, you got to manage. Make sure you manage your risk. Keep in mind, you always got to manage your risk. Now, looking at crude oil, I just wanted to point this out. We've talked about it hitting this ceiling area here. This is a rare major four-star resistance level in crude oil. Couldn't get its neck above there today with all the risk on. Starting to fall back just a little bit, consolidate. So keep an eye on this as we get through the week. And then let's finish off with the currencies. The euro, 110, right back up to 110 here today. Big area of resistance, but it did hold the 50-day moving average. So we're consolidating. Germany seems to, obviously got a big uplift with Germany and as well Spain, travel across the borders being open. But you also had some sentiment numbers. We talked about in the Morning Express today, early this morning and last week, the ones that look 6 months out, the expectations, those have come in stronger than expected. So, you know, overall, that's helped lift the euro, keep a bit under the euro, and then now you get this loosening of restrictions in the euro. Because remember, the dollar is a safe haven for now. But we do think the dollar is going to see, the U.S. is going to see that better growth. That's why we like the dollar long-term. At a pivotal level here in the euro. So see how we heading into tomorrow and through tomorrow. Now the Aussie, another pivotal level. 200-day moving average. You also have the scene of the crime. This is March 9th. Where Saudi Arabia is at Sunday and a Monday session, big whipsaw area in the Aussie. But this is where it all just started to fall apart. So big area, scene of the crime here, right below 67. Keep an eye on this here. A lot of data throughout the week. And is it going to be risk on? Aussie is just a great barometer for risk on. And now we like fading this move. However, you got to be very, very cautious in how you're doing it. Cannot over leverage until this thing starts to show any type of weakness. Now, looking as well, all that news and drama coming out of the UK over the weekend, you're going to see potentially a move towards loosening restrictions, despite the fact that they're one of the hardest hit countries. But overall, some good trendline resistance up here. Still, the 50-day moving average is now saying we're back above it, really closing above it for the first time, going back to first week of May. And that's a bullish signal. So we're ready, again, another inflection point. Currencies are finding themselves at a very interesting area. And another one, you don't always look at this. It is actually a tradable contract, the Euro Swiss. But overall, you get the move higher upon the announcement of that Euro bond, or the push for that Euro bond last week. And overall, sort of a little bit of a bull flag building here. If this thing breaks out, it's because the euro is broke above 110. Keep an eye on this. Support down here, 50-day moving average, consolidation. Or is it the Swiss that's going to break down from support and this nice consolidating wedge? We're going to get a move here. Now, we're not saying that this euro Swiss or the Swiss in general is going to have a certain direction. But what we are saying is you're going to get a move that involves the Swiss coming around the corner. We tend to think lower. We're prepared for lower, but again, it's going to be a matter here. What does the dollar do in the near term? And what does the euro do in the near term? And the Swiss does have that barometer of safe haven to it. It's not like it once was, but we're going to get a move. That's what we're looking at and pointing at here. And then lastly, that's it. Let's finish up. And so overall, if you have any questions, we're here to help. Give us a call, 312-278-0500. And remember, futures trading involves substantial risk of loss. It is not suitable for all investors.